Okay, so straight to him.
Here at the wedding. That's a good start, isn't it?
Here at the
wedding festival, and you probably won't hear me from this tractor, but this is the first time I've actually camped here. You're going to be going under this barbed wire now, because that's where my tent is.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, sorry. I was getting a bit confused. Yeah, because it's it is a bit funny because it's a Pogue song. I was convinced that their song was called Yeah Yeah Yeah. Also on Island Records for me, though. So I purposely made ours 5 years. And everybody said, oh yeah, is that a cover of the Pogue song then? I said, no, because it's the same title. I don't know. I made the biggest mistake ever made in titling the song, I think.
I don't dare answer the phone, and when you call, I still pretend that I'm not home. I don't want to see you anymore, oh love. It's not just me I'm thinking of.
Dave, why are you the only original widow left?
Probably the next one to go, is that what you mean?
People say, well, Dave Gedge is the wedding present. Well, you are the only original member.
I think it's because people change, really, you know, and people who were in the group originally suddenly find that they're not, it's not easy to carry on working, you know, and they move on to other things. I suppose it's my group because I formed it, but I think a lot of the thing is because, you know, possibly a fault of the media, but, you know, they do tend to focus on the singer, you know, possibly sometimes unwisely, because, you know, like, we all used to go to interviews, and then all the questions would be to me, you know, and no one had asked the drummer anything about the songs. And so after, like, a year, you're going to get a bit fed up, really. And then the worst case is when, you know, people, you know, like, your bass player will say something, and it'll be quoted to me. Because the journalist didn't know the bass player's name or something stupid like that. So after a while, they think, you know, why do I bother coming to these? No one cares what I say. And so eventually, people just associate me with the group.
What do you see from your experience with working with Steve Albini in the two albums before?
I think Steve Albini is definitely like a rock producer. It's very, it's a big sound, but it's very 90s and quite dark in some ways. And I think with Steve Fisk, he's got an encyclopedic knowledge of like, you know, weird cult groups from the 50s, you know, and you say, could we use this organ on it? And he goes, oh, well, funnily enough, here's the very organ that the Benches used, you know, and you play it, and it's, you know, it's more interesting, I think, than it, rather than just the usual sort of rock methods of making an LP. It was a lot more, like, really off-the-wall ideas. So it's like, you know, getting a traditional wedding present song, but then recording it in a very odd way.
Creative control over the wedding present?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's 100%. I think it's crucial.
Is that part of your contract?
Yeah. It always has been. I think it's... I don't want to write a song or make a record and then have some business person come and say, oh, you can't do that, you know, this has got to be changed, otherwise it won't get on this list, or, you know, you can't have the name of the band that small, so... Because that's not... It's not... You know, I'm not creating it anymore. I'm half creating it, and the advertisers or the marketing department's doing the rest of the creation, so it sort of destroys it. And I think it's very dangerous. When you get down that road, it's almost like, you know, you may as well make cornflakes.
It's got you back and that's all he wants. It's a lot more than I'm left with. Don't care. Now that you're gone. How much I miss you.